Welcome to the Popcorn Talk Network, for the online broadcast network that features movie discussion, news, and interviews. Press one.
Popcorn Talk. We talk movies.
My bad, guys. Wrong intro. We'll restart. Whoopsie.
Welcome to the Popcorn Talk Network, for the online broadcast network that features movie discussion, news, and interviews. Press one.
Popcorn Talk. We talk movies. From the Popcorn Talk Network, the online broadcast network for movie talk, this is Disney Movie News, bringing you the most up-to-date discussion and commentary in Disney content.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Disney Movie News, the show that unsurprisingly talks about Disney movie news. Here on Popcorn Talk, make sure you guys follow us along at The Popcorn Talk on Twitter and on YouTube at Popcorn Talk Network. I'm your host, Leo Camacho. You can follow me on Twitter at LeoZombie. And joining me over to my left are my two beautiful, gorgeous co-hosts. Oh, yeah. Go ahead and introduce yourselves.
Thank you. I'm James A. Janisse. You can follow me on Twitter at James A. Janisse. Or on YouTube at Practical Folks.
Practical Folks.
He does Disney stuff.
He does Disney content stuff. They're in some videos.
I'm in a few. You're in some of ours.
That's true.
That's why we brought you to cross-pollinate.
Yeah.
And who's that lovely lady?
I'm Sarah Snitch.
Oh, you know her.
Yeah, hostess with the mostest at Sarah Snitch on Twitter. And I'm Sarah Snitch on YouTube. And of course, you can find me and Leo at Thingamavlogs.
Thingamavlogs.
Thingamavlogs on
ghost
YouTube.
Ghost hosts. Can I make that joke every week?
No.
Cool.
Where's Keetin?
Keetin, well, here's what happened. Last week, she said that she liked the movie Planes.
Yeah.
That was the end of Keetin.
Well, we had her fight James to the death, and clearly.
Clearly, Keetin won.
She's resting. She's eating a victory.
At a wedding?
She's at a wedding.
Yeah, so we had her buddy
James.
Yeah,
Rapunzel and Flynn are getting married. But before we get into anything else, so it's a shame, but we got James here. Yep, and
it is a shame that you have me here.
It's a shame because you're not wearing a Disney shirt.
Oh. Yes. This is our thing.
Last week, we brought this up with Keetin. She didn't play along. This week, you come here. You don't play. First of all, let me show you.
You just look like you have a gray t-shirt on.
Yeah, but I don't. It's Boba Fett. I just want you guys to see this Boba Fett on my shirt
standing.
Because a Star Wars.
And you can't see it over my computer and the mic. This is my Seven Dwarves tea.
I'm sleepy, right,
that one's
happy.
Legit.
That one's... Well, this is Disney now.
It just looks
at
great.
At the bottom...
Okay, calm down, Sandman.
At the bottom, Doc has glasses on. The word Doc.
Yeah.
I think I win.
And the word dopey. No, there's nothing special.
No, nothing.
I thought maybe ears.
Nope.
But that's okay. We're going to forgive you this time. Maybe next time you come and host, you can wear a shirt and be appropriate and dress code.
Maybe I'll wear a little Smee hat. At work.
Get Disney bound to Smee.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. We got to do a Disney bound episode, writing that note down.
But at least one of us wore a Star Wars shirt.
I wore Star Wars because that's the hot button.
Yeah.
It's a hot topic.
Yes, it is.
Duel of the Fates.
Finally.
You got to get into it if you're going to do it.
I don't know, by the way,
I got to say, Duel of the Fates is probably, I was thinking this on my drive to work this morning because I think about Star Wars to an absurd amount. Duel of the Fates, probably the best thing to come out of the new trilogy. What would you say?
Yeah.
I would say that Duel of the Fates, double-sided lightsabers, and Obi-Wan Kenobi.
Jar Jar Binks.
Young Obi-Wan.
Okay.
Sarah, do you want the same fate as Keetin? Because we will kick you right. Let me write a note about the kick.
I've never thought about what my favorite thing about the pod racing.
That's because there's not. Oh!
Sorry, God, I don't know. I like it on Star Tours.
Then pod racing is okay, but then they added scenes to it, I think, for the Blu-ray release.
Oh, I didn't even. Oh, yeah, they did. They did add the additional racers, but I was okay with that because the Nintendo 64 pod racer game was amazing.
It was amazing. Yeah,
it was unreal.
But in the movie, you're just watching people die,
and all you hear is glug 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 glug. That's all you hear the whole time.
So what?
Let's get out of the past.
Let's
stop dwelling
in
the past and move to the future. Star Wars Episode 7, trailer number 3 of The Force Awakens.
Number one question.
Whoa.
Did you cry?
No. No, I didn't cry.
Did you tear up at all?
Look, I've told you guys, two things have made me cry in this life, maybe three.
Selena
was one of them.
He watched lots of episodes.
I've also watched Selena, and I have a heart.
You know where that's coming from, deep inside. No, I didn't cry, but I'm not gonna lie, I did get that deep, fuzzy feeling way in there where I went, you know that feeling. Yeah, I had to hold in the tears.
That almost sounded like a pod racer.
That's how I'm going to cry from now. I'm like, babe, listen, I just had a hard day.
I don't even really remember the trailer very well, so can you give me your favorite parts?
She just blacked out from
I blacked out from
Here's,
awesome.
Here's, I mean, man, I got it. First of all, it's pretty. It's a really pretty
it's
movie.
It's beautiful.
The colors are saturated to the right amount. Mm-hmm. And JJ has a thing, you know, he likes to move the camera very organically. So he likes to be in the shots with his Steadicam. They shake a little bit. He likes to circle around actors. He likes to move in. He likes that Spielberg stare. He tries to capture that. So it's very organic, and you feel like you're there.
The shot with Finn.
That's the one.
And Oscar Isaac.
Yeah.
When they're like... It's beautiful.
That was my favorite. So Oscar Isaac's character gets off of his X-Wing, walks around and sees Finn walking. He pats him on the back. Everybody's getting ready to go to battle, apparently. And Finn gives him this look like, what have I gotten myself into? I'm literally on the opposite side because he's a TIE fighter pilot. Mm-hmm. And that moment was just like encompassed the feeling of this movie.
How do you guys know so much about the characters?
Because he crashes in a TIE fighter in the new planet. I forget what it's called. It starts with a J.
In what?
Jakor?
I don't know anything.
Yeah, something like
that. There's a K.
Jakan.
Everyone knows all the new characters' names, and I know nothing.
That's because I'm a Star Wars
BB-8.
Nuts. That's the only one. New character. Have you heard the way he sounds?
No.
He's like whoop whoop whoop. Yeah, he sounds like a Furby with the batteries running out.
That face that you made just now. Whoop, whoop, whoop.
No, it's amazing. And I also like watching the trailer,
it's in the heavens.
When she goes spelunking into the crashed Star Destroyer. Mm-hmm. I thought that was really cool. I don't know. There's something about
it's like exploring the past.
Yeah, because you never see a character to scale with a Star Destroyer. You see the Star Destroyers floating in space amongst other massive ships,
or you see them crashing into the second Death Star.
You do, but the Death Star is the size of like a moon, so that still the references are huge. This is the first time you see a human in comparison to multiple chambers, which shows you just how enormous they are. I mean, they're essentially floating continents, which is well, they made them a little small. They're like cities in this.
Well, there are Star Destroyers and there are Superstar Destroyers.
Well, let's not get into this. This was just a regular Star. Calm down.
All right.
Where?
Because if you want to talk about Imperial classes,
we can really. But the cool thing is about it, it's okay. Well, so look, as you can see in the trailer, they're fighting amongst the ruins, which are now sort of like a place to visit on the planet, because you don't find crashed Star Destroyers very often.
What did you learn about the movie from the trailer that you didn't maybe
know
before? Well,
you learn that Finn wields a lightsaber. Well, I mean, you already kind of learned this in the last one, but Finn uses a lightsaber. You learn that the villain, what's it? Is it Kylo Ren or Ren?
Yes.
Kylo Ren. Yeah, Kylo Ren.
Kylo Ren. Kylo Ren.
He's basically a Vader fanboy, super fanboy.
Yeah, he's like, I'm gonna finish your job.
You started. Yeah. Yeah.
And he sounds awesome.
He sounds really good.
Who's the actor? Is it Adam from Girls?
Yeah, yeah. Yes. Adam from Girls.
Love him.
Which
the best part of Girls.
Yeah, and then you have Brienne of Tarth as the super trooper.
I love that.
We haven't really seen too much
those
of her.
Those are the two.
But you do see her strutting, walking, looking like.
Those are the two actors I'm most excited about.
Looking like a boss over there. You hear the crackle of the broken saber for the first time. You hear him ignite it, but in this one, he's holding it out, and you hear like the kind of snaps of the saber, which was pretty cool.
Mm-hmm. You see Leia for the first time.
Literally, that's all I care about.
And she's not, and she's aged.
Yeah.
Hollywood didn't try to hide it too much.
Oh, yeah. People were surprised about that.
I don't know why.
I don't know. Yeah, like, I guess.
I don't know what people thought they were going to do to her.
Yeah.
What are they going to do?
And makeup,
like too much makeup.
Yeah, like they could have, you know.
They could have.
I guess.
I'm glad they did.
There's a couple of controversies though surrounding this. Have you heard this?
Oh.
So the first one is the plain one where they're talking about the trailer was released during a football game.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's huge. Yeah. And what they're trying to say is the nerds are sold, right? We got you where we want you. And so now they're trying to appeal to the general public, and they release this. Of course, this could also be a marketing tactic, which has been used forever to get people to watch that channel at that time, which is a football, a lot of money generated. But there's a big thing. It's like that trailer wasn't meant for us. It was meant for the normies.
Well, I would like to see the ratings. Compared, like the first half of the game compared to the second half of the game.
Oh, yeah.
For the game, you know, itself.
Yeah, and then there is, right after that, the tickets went on sale.
Yeah.
Oh, and, my God. Actually, they went on earlier.
They went earlier, yeah. It got prolonged.
Broke but, Fandango.
It broke. It literally
Straight
broke
up
everything.
Broke Fandango.
Yeah, it broke many websites.
It literally broke Kim and Kanye's internet. That's how good it was.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know if you knew that. So 24-hour sales, it accounted for 95% of movietickets.com sales. And estimated in a 24-hour period, it is estimated, because they didn't release numbers, but it's estimated that it sold $6.5 million worth of tickets in the first 24 hours,
yes.
Which shatters every other record. The highest up to that point was barely over a million.
Well, are you expecting this to be the highest grossing
yes,
movie of all time?
Without question. Without question.
I feel like every movie lately is the highest grossing
yeah,
of all time.
Well,
I'm like,
really
how is
that's,
Frozen?
That's because we're perpetually moving into like, you know, just a fandom-based, nostalgic-based sort of market where all that geekdom and millennials with money are just pouring whatever they have. And everybody's trying to one-up, because that's a fan culture now. It's like, how much more of a fan can I be than you? Like, look at Comic-Con. It's fans of being fans. You go, you don't even care about the subject matter. You just want to go to Comic-Con to see it.
Yeah.
And so now everybody's got to be part of that first experience, because that's what you only get the first one. After
Did you buy your ticket?
Sarah picked them up for us.
Yeah. I was nervous. You like weren't on it.
I wasn't on it because I was hoping it would be a group thing. And since no one contacted me, I was just sitting in my room crying like a lonely Star
Low
Wars
key,
nerd.
Thank God I bought
Good thing my girlfriend's responsible.
Good job.
I have to tell you, Leo, that Camille in the comments says that she bought Force Awakens tickets because of your obsession with Star Wars.
Really?
She probably wasn't going to see it.
Camille.
Which is weird.
Yeah, that's
but
weird.
No, I mean, I like
We being, know Camille. She watches
I awakened the Force in her.
Oh. You did. You created a new Star Wars fan.
I'm going to start my own Jedi Alliance, just so you guys know. Speaking of which, there's a show on this network called Jedi Alliance.
Uh-huh.
And if you guys, they just did a whole full hour review of the trailer itself. So I know we're going at length here, but if you want to watch an entire podcast about that, check out their
they
video.
They go frame by frame.
They literally break down the JPEG fragment noise.
Here? What
do
we see here?
But Star Wars, I could literally talk about Star Wars forever. Are you guys excited? Bottom line.
Oh, yeah.
You got your tickets?
Yeah, I got my tickets.
Four
tickets.
Out of five critics.
Let me ask let me ask you guys real quick. Favorite Star Wars character?
Oof.
And I'm not going to ask your favorite movie because Sarah doesn't know the order
can
of the
I
movies.
Tell, I do know the order of the movies. Can I tell? Wait, say it and then I have to tell a story.
Go ahead.
Ki-Adi-Mundi. I like his little
you
cone
mean
head.
You mean Ki-Adi-Mundi?
Is that how you, is that the
Oh my God. No, you're trolling, right?
No, I'm dead serious.
Oh my God!
Yeah,
he originally had
a purple saber in original lore and canon, but
then Mace. To
Mace was supposed to be the only one, so he loses it. But by the way, in the process of creating, they kind of retconned it. The process of creating a purple saber is like a really distinguished fighter's thing to do. He loses his, but because they both did that, he and Mace Windu have a really deep bond as fighters.
Oh, that's
just
nice.
Throwing that out there. Go ahead, Sarah.
So. Before my first date with Leo, I knew that he was a big Star Wars fan. And so I was like with my friends and my roommates and I was like, guys, like, what if he asks me who my favorite Star Wars character
You're
is?
You're cute and all.
I have to have a really like cool answer. Like just like, you know, like, oh, this is your favorite Star Wars. Oh, that's like a
What'd you text
a,
me?
That's a
tell
cool
him,
answer.
Tell him what you told
No,
text.
I'm not going to, no.
She
but
said,
like
she
we were talking.
Said, like nonsense, moisture evaporators.
No, but like I really like put a lot, I did like a lot of research. I like read a lot about Expanded Universe before our first date. And I was like, all right, if he asks me, I'm going to say it's Mara Jade. And then
good.
Later, much later, he was like, I would have thought you were such a poser if you said Mara Jade.
I would have said
I don't have a favorite character. I don't know.
R2-D2. That's okay. I'll take it. Do you know my favorite Expanded Universe? Oh,
that
was going to say Dash Rendar and Kyle Katarn are like my two of my favorite
characters. AK-47.
AK-47, that's a gun.
My favorite character.
You mean IG-88?
Knights of the Old Republic.
My favorite character is...
Which IG-88? There's A, B, C, and D.
That is true. No, he's talking old. He went Old Republic.
The Millennium Falcon.
Is your favorite ship?
Is my favorite character.
How about the Outrider? Oh, it kind of is a character.
I know, that's why I said it.
Did I? I'm the one who told you that.
No, you didn't. I thought of that on my own.
Okay.
I'm really cool.
Guess who's fighting tonight?
I didn't come here to like be in the middle of a lover spat, so.
I thought that was a really cool answer that I just thought of.
I'm glad you guys could talk about this with me, but we can't talk about this.
I know,
forever.
We gotta move on.
Let's move on.
What do you want to talk about?
Next piece of news I have here.
All right.
Let's stay in the
as
season
important
and the holiday.
As the new Star Wars trailer and the movie.
First of all, you need to stop right there because nothing's as important as that.
No.
By the way, are people in the chat? They loving Star Wars?
Yeah, no, they're
loving
it.
Star Wars.
They're loving
guys,
it.
Guys, I want you all to tweet at me.
Yoda's my favorite.
Yoda, okay.
Of course, has been awakened.
Nice.
Is Chewbacca
like
gonna die?
He can...
I like old Yoda.
I like old Yoda.
You like puppet Yoda.
Yeah.
He was good.
Yeah.
He was wise. I'm glad. Okay, I want everyone to tweet at me your favorite Star Wars characters. Let's get into some discussion. I want to see the most obscure.
Also, if you're watching this not live, leave it in the comments.
Leave it in the comments below.
Do that too.
Because I do go back and check. I'm like, you're clearly wrong. Okay, so let's move on. Holiday spirit. It's October. We got Halloween coming up. Mm-hmm. And recently at the Telrude Horror Show Film Festival, /film.com has reported, allegedly, that the director, Henry Selick, has clearly stated whether or not Nightmare Before Christmas is a Christmas movie mm-hmm. or a Halloween movie. And did you read the article?
I did.
You did read the article.
I am very informed.
He did his homework.
He did his homework. All right, well, then I can't ask you which one you think. Well, okay, before I even tell the audience what he says it is, prior to reading this, mm-hmm. how do you feel about the movie? What is it to you?
I have always felt that it was a Halloween
movie.
I don't know. I saw it really late in life. I saw it in college.
What did you feel deep in your soul?
That might offer you a more objective.
Yeah.
I feel like it was a Halloween movie.
Halloween movie?
Yeah.
I always felt I've always been toured. But
toured.
I was toured up.
Torn.
I toured it up. I toured all over it. I always felt it was a Halloween, but I always felt it was a Christmas movie wrapped in a Halloween costume. And Henry Selick has reported that it is, in fact, according to him, a Halloween movie.
It makes
By the
sense.
Way, like a little girl asked him, like, what is it? And he said it was a Halloween movie. So that adds to the credibility. But I have some arguments against that. I think it's actually a Christmas movie.
I have some counter-arguments.
Okay, well, it's okay to be wrong, so listen.
All right.
It's a Christmas movie because Christmas is in the title of the movie.
Nightmare Before.
It's not the Halloween Before Christmas comes up. So let's
no
do
no.
Stuff.
But if you accept that, you know, Halloween is a nightmarish kind of holiday, and it takes place in fact before Christmas in the calendar year.
That's fine, but that doesn't mean Nightmare on Elm Street is a Halloween movie. I mean, although it is associated with Halloween, it's not a Halloween movie like Hocus Pocus. Listen, and here's the other thing.
Oh my God, he's
the
so
movie,
serious about this. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm. You never actually see Halloween take place in the movie. You see Christmas.
It's
take
Halloween
place.
Every day in Halloween Town.
No. But when he goes to the real world, he comes back from the real world after Halloween, and then goes back to the real world during Christmas.
Wait. I don't think there's a real world.
Yeah, they live in a magical world.
Like when he's like being Santa.
Yeah, remember one time a year they can go out. Remember he has to deliver the presents and he delivers Halloween scary presents on Christmas.
Okay. Halloween is still once per year. Remember, because the mayor the next day says only 364 more days
to
Halloween.
Yeah, I think we enter it right on
good like, evidence.
The conclusion honestly only of ever Halloween. Seen it like
you do,
twice.
You do.
In fact, you know that opening song, maybe that was part of Halloween.
Yeah, and also there's a song literally about Christmas. Well, I guess it's a Halloween song, so we can count it.
Yeah, they're saying this is Halloween.
Yeah, they're saying
they're not saying this is Halloween Town.
Yeah.
They say making Christmas.
Making Christmas.
First of all, okay. Leo doesn't hear it, but he says Christmas so funny.
Because I'm Hispanic, so she's being racist slightly.
Being racist, Christmas.
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 Listen, it's just like, I love it. It's like my
listen,
favorite thing about
I have
Leo.
A little bit of an accent. Spanish was my first language.
I love it.
My A's are
but
flat.
He usually is like, no, you're just hearing it.
Oh my gosh. You're just hearing it. Mm-hmm. But I'm jealous. You guys have stuff in your cups.
Yeah.
I didn't
you can pretend to drink. Whoa. Don't spill that invisible liquid all.
Sorry about that. So anyway,
right, well,
so
now
we've done
that.
That
like,
what
yeah.
does the chat room feel? I just want to see a couple
Everyone's
of responses.
Everyone's like Halloween.
Everyone's
it's a Halloween movie. It's Halloween.
So everybody in their chat room's on. That's fine, guys. That's fine. I still love you, though.
You're on an island.
I'm on an island.
Okay, now that like world crisis question has been answered.
Yeah.
What I am really excited to talk about. Oh, we're going to wait a second.
Okay.
We're going to talk about your favorite Disney movie.
This yeah, want to talk about my movie? You want to go there?
Yeah.
Okay, so my favorite Disney. You know my favorite Disney movie?
Did you watch the last episode? He said it.
I did.
Quiz time! What's Leo's favorite movie?
If you get it wrong, you have to do 700 push-ups.
James.
Which you can
James,
do.
James.
It was it was Brother Bear.
Actually, that's like in my like top.
Oh
10.
Look, it's Chelsea.
Oh, Chelsea's in chat. What's up, Chelsea?
Chelsea is James's girlfriend, also
his
on Practical
life,
Folks.
She is.
She's amazing.
Very we have a cat.
Chelsea.
One of the funniest people I've ever met.
Yes.
Yeah. Her comedic.
You're like top 8. Mm-hmm.
I mean, you're not getting off the hook. What's his favorite movie?
Yeah.
Oh no.
It's getting real.
Here's a hint. It's one of
God,
the characters he looks like,
her.
But not the one you
but
think.
No, it's not Little Mermaid.
I don't look like the Little Mermaid, FYI.
Oh,
although I did once.
Is it Aladdin?
It is a Latino.
Yes.
Aladdin. Congratulations. You get 3 wishes. The first wish is for me to tell you my story.
so Aladdin, I get 3 wishes, but you decide.
You get them. I choose them.
Okay,
that's how it works.
Fair.
I have
that's
the
fair.
Lamp, but I'm thinking of you when I make the wish. Mm-hmm. So recently, because you know they just released the Blu-ray of Aladdin, so the directors, Ron Clement and John Musker, have confirmed a fan theory that's been floating around the internet, which I didn't know was a fan theory. And they have confirmed that the peddler at the opening of the movie Aladdin, you know, who sings
Arabian Nights.
Yeah. The controversial song.
The song, yeah, yes. It is very controversial. Mm-hmm. He is the genie. He's portraying the narrator and telling you the story. And they confirm that that is, in fact, the genie, because it is Robin Williams' voice. He even has a red sash and blue. But that's the whole thing, is I never knew it was a fan theory. I just always knew.
You thought it was true. Yeah. Well, didn't they say there was a scene that
no,
was cut out?
No, but I never even read it on the internet. Oh, they did. I didn't catch that part. Oh.
There was a scene.
Inform us.
Hold on, I got to
It's like storyboarded. Sure it right.
They had a scene at the end that was like a big reveal.
Oh, that
and they
would
cut
make
it out.
Sense.
Yeah.
That would make sense. But I don't know, as a kid, it was just intuitive. I'm like, well, who can tell this story long after the story has passed? The genie, because he's immortal. And he's literally wearing the same colors as the genie, has the genie's beard, is voiced the same voice as the genie.
I never
is making magical things appear. Really?
I never caught on to that until I was an adult.
Dude,
I didn't as a kid.
Yeah.
Wow. I didn't as a kid for sure. I wasn't
Man.
That smart.
I didn't think it was Robin Williams. Dude had an accent.
Yeah, he's Robin Williams.
Ah, you did not know this. Okay. Mm.
That was...
I was trying to do his impression.
Good job.
Right. You know what? I'm done. Oh,
this is a fan theory I'm okay with, though. What?
Okay. No, go ahead.
This is just like we were talking last time about fan theories, and some of them I do not like the Pixar theory.
There's many, mm-hmm. many.
But this,
oh,
yeah.
Oh, yeah. The every...
Yeah.
Wait, you don't like that fan theory?
No.
Yeah, why would you?
Where everything's linked.
I don't
yeah.
like people pushing boundaries. No.
Okay.
She's
pushing my buttons.
Jesus.
But I do like this one.
Okay.
Because it's simple. It's like a...
A little tidbit, little snack.
A little touch.
A little Disney snack.
But he
doesn't change the story at all.
But he refuted other theories in that same interview.
Yeah, do you remember them?
Yeah. It does not take place in a post-apocalyptic world.
Oh, yeah, that's
oh,
right.
Oh, yeah, which I hate that one. I'm like,
you
no,
hate
that
it?
One was silly.
I don't know.
It's just
dumb. Oh, no, no. No, you know what one he didn't address is that can the genie time travel, which that one well, would make
but
sense.
But he can time travel.
Well, both of those theories come from the fact that he does pop culture references.
Yeah.
They're
yeah.
like, oh, he must be from...
He's
the
Jack Nicholson.
But I would rather him be able to time travel than it takes place in the future.
Oh, yeah.
Just like anybody who ever... I don't know.
I mean, he says he's going to Disneyland.
Yeah. I know. Right?
Well, it's like phenomenal cosmic powers. It could not be real. You know, like time and space do not. I mean, yeah. But the thing is, he can shrink infinitesimally. We'll just go infinitely small. So is it really itty bitty? Because that's all relevant. Time and space. You know what I'm saying?
You know what I'm saying. Right.
The genie is Doctor Who, by the way. He wears blue like the TARDIS.
Yeah.
Or Doc Brown.
Great
Back
Scott
to the Future
Marty.
Day.
Oh, yeah, by the way, today.
Happy Back to the Future Day.
Happy Back to the Future Day if you're watching this live.
We made it, guys.
We made it.
We made it.
To the future.
The future is now.
Mm-hmm.
The future is today. Back to the past tomorrow.
Yep.
Yeah, no, that was good. It's not a fan theory, in my opinion, but that was good.
Yeah.
Moving forward.
This is my favorite thing to talk about.
Bring it, Sarah.
I love Pixar more than everything.
You like Pixar more than traditional Disney?
You know, I think they're doing better things than Disney lately.
They're more
progressive. Right now?
Well, maybe not right now, but they had been for a long time, and I think they will again.
I see.
With a Good Dinosaur. I have a lot of faith in Good Dinosaur.
Did you lose faith?
I did. I was like the only person in the world who didn't like Inside Out. Mm. And
did you like it, James?
Yeah. I don't want to talk
about it. I loved Inside Out because I have an imagination.
Oh, my God. Stop it. The imagination and Bing Bong was the only good part of Inside Out, so I'm with you there.
Abstract thinking.
Okay.
I just want to say, I feel sorry for all the parents out there who had their... Because, I mean, like, my girlfriend was running around the house for the next 2 months going, Bing Bong, Bing Bong. Like, if I had to deal with that, I'm so sorry for the parents.
Let's play. But, like, I'm not a huge fan of Brave, not a huge fan of Monsters U, not a huge fan of Inside Out, but, like, I think Good Dinosaur is going to be so good.
Yeah.
This is totally separate from what I want to talk about, but they opened a preview at Disney California Adventure.
Yeah, we recently went to
do, like, previews of, like, Tomorrowland and Big Hero 6. They do, like, whatever the next movie is, show extended footage, and got me so pumped.
Nice.
They showed it was mostly what they had at D23, but they had a few other things. But the cool thing is it's in the Bugs Life Theater, and so it was interactive.
Oh my God.
Really creative how they use the interactive elements. So there's like gusts of wind that come at you, the seats move and they poke you in the bottom, which is quite surprising and alarming, and really questions your security. And so that happens, water squirts at you, all kinds of stuff, and it's all relevant to what's happening on the screen. But one thing that I thought I noticed, and a buddy of mine who was with us also thought he noticed, was that... because they've had time between all the old trailers and this experience, I feel because first of all, before I even get to that, I have to, you know, set this up. The big complaint was the contrast between Arlo and the scenery. Because he's so gummy and cartoony, and the scenery is so picturesque. You know,
but the scenery is not actual footage. Like
no,
like
no,
the
it's
other,
all CGI.
Like the bad dinosaur.
But still, like stylistically speaking, they were very the they contra- yeah the bad dinosaur. Well, there was
Disney
also that
dinosaur.
Ill-tempered dinosaur, disgruntled dinosaur. But you know, so I mean, did you ever have any thoughts about that? Did you think that was that off-putting to you? Because that was the big complaint.
Well,
on
I
the
haven't
world
seen
of the web.
I haven't seen this preview.
Well, no, but
no,
any,
but like
any
have you seen the trailer?
Yes. I didn't notice it. So,
no, really?
I'm not off.
You're being picky.
Look, I'm an artist. That's what I do. But anyways, what I was trying to get at last week on the show, I was saying I was kind of complaining that it was a concern that the contrast was too severe. Mm-hmm. But after this particular preview, it looks like it appears maybe it was the format that I was seeing it in. It looks like they re-rendered it and it blended much nicer. You could see the scales better on Arlo's skin. You could see dirt on his on his skin as well. He just flowed more seamlessly through the environment, which
that's
was
nice.
Gave me a lot of hope for that. Because although the movie looks like it'll be fine, it'll be fun. You know, I want it to look good too. It's what Pixar is.
I have a question.
Yes.
How come I haven't heard anything about Zootopia, which is like the next one?
D23 showed a bunch about it. It was the first time like there was any real
everyone's
news.
Talking about like Moana and Good Dinosaur.
More immediate.
I don't know. Yeah. Well, yeah. No, Zootopia is coming out before Moana.
Oh, that's true. That's true, yeah.
That's why I'm confused.
I don't know, man. I'm excited about that one too.
I'm really excited.
Like the footage that they showed at D23 was so funny.
First of all,
I've only seen that like little teaser trailer.
No, where they're just on the white background.
We saw a scene.
Oh my God.
It was
hysterical.
We were crying.
All right, cool.
I was literally like Selena level crying.
except from happiness. I don't know why no one's talking about it though. It's like got a lot of celebrities in it.
It is strange. Yeah. But first of all, one of the reasons I really love Disney is their use of anthropomorphic animals. Mm-hmm. Because I'm just a huge animal nut. I used to want to be a zoologist. I don't know if you knew that about me. I have a little trivia for you guys afterwards too. But I'm a huge animal guy. This is anthropomorphic animals, Disney's roots. Like, it's basically, I mean, Robin Hood was what really sucked me in, right? And he's an anthropomorphic fox. This movie's about one. So I'm really, really excited. The stylized world is amazing. You get all sorts of ecosystems included in their city. It's just super, super
nothing
cool.
Nothing I love more than ecosystems.
Look.
Get me excited about them.
Like, you want to talk about nerdery. no, I'm super. You're right, though. No one's talking. But that's because there's not that much info available.
Well, there's lots.
No, but I mean.
We know the whole plot.
Yeah, no, but I mean, like yes, but it's not, like, out there.
I think it's purposefully not being talked about by Disney.
Why?
I feel like, because I feel like they want to focus on Good Dinosaur. Even though we think Pixar and Disney are so different, they're really not anymore.
Yeah.
And, like, they're probably like, no, like, let's get them amped.
Yeah.
And let's just wait to, like, drop some more stuff.
That is true. They don't want, yes, right, they don't want to cross signals to animal movies.
Also, I mean, I'm assuming Zootopia has been in development for a long time. I wonder if after Frozen... did huge, they were like, ooh, maybe we should have just gone straight to another princess movie.
Yeah. Well, that is why they're amping up Moana. I mean, it could be why they're amping up Moana.
Yeah.
But, I mean, you don't want to get your signals crossed either. So two animal movie, especially when one's not even coming out immediately, you got to push the first one.
Yeah.
And I know from, like, experience, you know, talking to Disney, they really worry about the next project.
No big deal.
Right. But Moana's a big it's just Disney movie news. But Moana's a big deal because there's Disney's setting a lot of things right with this movie. There's a lot of proper representation going on.
Yeah.
There's a lot of cool stories behind it. And so
you got The Rock.
Right, you got The Rock.
Yeah.
You just have a lot of positive things that go into making this movie, so they have a lot of extra stories to tell.
Someone in the comments says, do you think the hype of Star Wars will overshadow Good Dinosaur even though Good Dinosaur comes out a month before? I think no.
Let's just put it this way. It has a month to prove itself.
I think there's like a Venn diagram
That's
of people who are going to see, you know, like there are people who are going to see Good Dinosaur and not see Star Wars, but probably not that many.
Yeah.
And there is a huge chunk of people who are going to see both.
Yeah.
And then there's a whole bunch of people seeing Star
Wars
who do not care about Good
Dinosaur. My Venn diagram just looks like a pizza. It's one circle and it's delicious.
Yeah.
When we saw the teaser at DCA, Leo was like, did you know that there was a Easter egg for Good Dinosaur?
And it was one of those moments when Sarah went, what?
Yeah, I know. And he loves this. He loves it when he can say something I didn't know about. But it's probably because I like pushed Inside Out so far out of my head. I was like, I want to forget that.
You went outside in.
I want to lose that memory in that pit of despair or whatever
it
is in that
movie. Calm down over there.
You know what movie features really good metaphors for that process?
That's literally, yeah.
And set out. Yeah, okay. You've got your priorities and set out.
It's really good.
If I had an island of personality, one would be Pixar.
Pixar Island, Disney Island, Harry Potter Island. I mean, it's a great world. It's a whimsical world.
Tell us.
Continue with that.
So the big old Triceratops, mm-hmm. which is my favorite dinosaur, because mm-hmm.
Sarah.
Triceratops.
Okay. I get it.
Aha!
2 points for Gryffindor.
Appears in one of Riley's memories when they are taking a photo at like a national park.
Which is like that same dinosaur thing we have out here in Palm Springs.
Is that the peewee?
It's like the
dinosaurs?
Peewee one, yeah.
Yeah.
Peewee's Big Adventure.
So, you know, Pixar, classically, dropping Easter eggs.
And there's something I want to point out. It's the same dinosaur's... it's the same dinosaur's face, but they're not actually the same dinosaur in the shot.
It's probably actually Trixie from Toy Story.
They do look very similar, but no, it's definitely him because he has a cross-eyed, and he looks all...
My favorite part of Toy Story.
But what I want to say is, do you know, I mean, I don't know if they've officially announced this, but just by looking at him and analyzing, do you know what kind of dinosaur the one from The Good Dinosaur is? It's not a Triceratops.
Ooh, it's not a Triceratops.
Oh my god, guys.
No, because a Triceratops, you know what Triceratops means?
It just has a solid fin.
I get it. Three. Mm-hmm. I love
it. Can still be your favorite. It's okay for you to be wrong for this.
Was it going to be like a quad ceratops? It could still be Sarah.
That's not real.
That would be four horns, but look at that. How many horns is that?
So many.
Yeah. I have the name here, and I want to see if you guys know.
Oh, but no. I think the horns that you're looking at don't count towards the tops.
They do.
Oh, I thought that was
But they don't. Okay, I'll tell you this much.
Okay.
It's not like Quinceratops, which is a dinosaur, by the way.
What is it?
It is called.
Quinceratops?
Quinceratops.
Quinceratops. Yes. Each one of those birds is 16 or 15. So it's actually called, I wrote it down so I wouldn't mispronounce it because I've always seen it written. I always talk to myself in my head. It's called a.
Starts with an R?
Huh?
No.
No, it starts with an S.
Okay.
Styracosaurus.
That's not real.
Yeah, it is.
You're not real.
Yes, Styracosaurus.
What period did it live in?
Cretaceous.
Everyone cool.
Leo knows a lot about dinosaurs and animals.
Hey, you guys want a fun dinosaur fact?
Yeah.
Always.
Did you know that the Tyrannosaurus Rex existed closer to the time of the pyramids than it did to the time that the Stegosaurus was alive?
I did know that.
Hey guys, listen.
Everyone just
it's time for emotional dinosaur
ease their pants.
Leo Camacho. Come on, that's a cool fact.
That's pretty cool.
We haven't even gotten.
But I mean, you could.
But you know who did know that?
What?
It was Doc and Marty because they traveled back in time to verify. I just wanted to be in theme of the day.
They did.
No, oh, okay. But they had a time machine. Who knows what they did?
Oh man,
I don't think they used it outside of the times we saw them use it.
Sarah. Let's get out of dinosaur land. That's where I live.
Okay,
that's
but my within home. The theme of good dinosaur.
Look, if I had a world, it would be inhabited by Star Wars and dinosaurs.
Okay, and mine would be just
Pixar. It would just be Pixar. So take us to your world.
Like some of the things that I love, maybe even more than certain Pixar movies, are Pixar shorts.
Oh, yeah.
You are a nut for Pixar shorts.
I love Pixar shorts.
They're always so good.
And I like Pixar tank tops when it's warm, but Pixar shorts are always comfortable. That's a clothing joke.
Nice.
I feel like Pixar shorts exemplify their ability to storytell.
Yeah.
Like, yeah.
Well, literally, half of them don't even have words in them.
I know. Yeah. My favorite ones don't have words.
Paperman is in Pixar. I'm just going to.
James, I just want to say it was nice. All the times you came over to our house was great, but you're not allowed over now.
I'm sorry.
It's okay. So, aside from paper. What's your favorite Pixar short?
Now he's afraid to answer.
You're like,
I don't want to talk anymore.
What's yours? What's your favorite Pixar?
That's what I was hoping you would go so I could think about that.
Mine is La Luna.
What's that one?
La Luna.
It's with the little Italian boy on the moon. No, it was before Brave.
Okay. Oh, I didn't see Brave in theater. I saw it on an airplane.
Really? I
saw it on an airplane. Much better than I've been led to believe.
No, it was good.
Yeah, I like
you
it.
Should go watch La Luna. Okay.
Watch this, James. My favorite is Feast.
He's just trolling me.
Feast is okay.
No, it's a Disney show. Oh, that's why I said it.
Yikes.
Sorry.
What was the most recent one?
The volcano one.
Oh, I love that one.
It was alright.
I love you.
I love you too.
That song was very catchy.
Alright. Yeah. Let's move on.
Did you even give your favorite one though?
Mm. Oh, I'm gonna go with Jerry's Game.
Nice.
Classic.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
Yeah. It was cool. I mean, at the time it came out, it was really impressive. Mm-hmm. But we got a new short.
Yes.
We got a new short. Coming out with the El Dinosauro Bueno.
Excuse me?
The Good Dinosaur.
Yeah, The Good Dinosaur.
Oh. It's called Sanjay's Super Team.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
It is the first Pixar anything to be directed by an Indian director.
Oh.
And it's based off his life. And his childhood growing up with, right. like, a very religious household. And
he was caught between Western culture.
Yeah, caught between cultures and being super into TV shows and superheroes. And mm-hmm. then, like, having a daydream about the Indian gods mm-hmm, mm-hmm. as superheroes.
As superheroes. But, like, literal superheroes, like X-Men superheroes.
Yeah, like...
Yeah, yeah, because he didn't like studying them traditionally because it was a bit boring, so he gave it some of that Western spin, and he was just like, dude, they like shoot laser beams.
You know what I mean? Also the first time they've pretty ever cool. like mentioned or hint or like shown religion in yeah. a Pixar anything.
Except which is a big deal. When Hercules Buzz go to pray.
Yeah, I don't want to brush the bubble, but Hercules was like a big deal and it was all about gods. You know what I mean? Yeah.
Pixar.
Oh, Pixar was it's the first for that.
We're really getting our Pixar Disney's.
I know. We need to learn to Pixar and choose our battles.
God. Mm.
Does it do this all the time?
The worst was at D23. I went to a panel where it was like the like top people at Pixar, John Lasseter and all of them were there, and someone got up and asked a question about Tangled.
Oh
and
my
And I was like
God. You know,
you're wasting everyone's time, and I'm so embarrassed for you.
It must be the same look when someone comes up to Elijah Wood and asks for Daniel Radcliffe's autograph. I feel like it's a similar face. But yeah, no, I'm really excited. Actually, they showed some screens. There was the clip that they released was very short.
You know, I've seen it already.
Yeah, humble brag.
You've seen the whole short?
Yeah.
Ooh.
I have seen
yeah,
it.
Yeah, so give us your thoughts. Yeah.
It's good.
Without no spoilers.
It's not my favorite. It's just like...
Well, don't get your hopes up, everybody.
I mean, it's just like La Luna made me cry, and like Lava made me cry. Uh-huh. This didn't make me cry. I remember feeling really emotional.
Which is funny, because Lava didn't really do it for me.
God.
Thanks.
Yeah. A lot of... I don't know, man.
I kind of want Lava to end with him like underwater.
Everyone said that. Everyone like wanted it to end horribly.
Yeah.
Nah, you don't do that.
It's pathos.
You don't say.
Yeah.
Pathos. I'm excited about this one because I'm a big superhero guy, obviously, and it just looks cool. I like
it's
that
really
there's
cute.
Like an ethnic backing. I'm really
big
on that.
I like that.
Sarah's really opened up my heart, my mind to. You know, to the whole
Hinduism?
Cultural
no,
to sensitivity.
Like, yeah, yeah. Representation. Yeah.
Well,
in the
because like you know, I didn't even know what Canada is a person of color for the longest time, and so she was like, "FYI," I was like, "What?" And then I watched
Book of Life,
and I was like, my mind was
which
blown.
Which is not Disney, but
it's not.
Such a good movie.
You guys need to watch that,
dude.
Step outside Disney World for a second.
Gotta watch.
Literally, my statement to Sarah after the movie was over.
Your eyes are telling me that this is like an emergency.
Look,
it's like life changing.
When the movie was over, being Hispanic. I looked at Sarah and I said, I would have given any of my worldly possessions to be part of the making of that film because it was just so well made. Mm-hmm. I loved it. I love everything about it. Anyway.
And it like spoke to you.
And it really spoke
culture.
To me. Yeah, it was really cool. So that's why I think this movie will be very, very
cool.
Yeah,
I'm really excited.
Yeah, it'll be dope.
It'll be cool.
Let's see, what else we got?
Sanjay.
Sanjay's cool. Sanjay's great. Moving on, we got some news about BATB. You know what that is? Beauty and the Beast.
Beauty and the Beast.
The Beauty and the Beast. So it turns out that the live-action Beauty and the Beast... By the way, have you seen any of the footage for this movie?
I haven't seen
not footage.
Footage.
I've seen some pictures. Not footage.
There's like footage. We saw footage at D23. We saw footage at D23.
Yeah, like 5 seconds.
Or, excuse me, footage can also be photography.
No.
Footage. No,
listen,
have you seen
can you
stills?
Can you roll with me? I thought you were my boy.
I've seen some stills.
Okay.
Yes, thank you, Sarah.
Fired. Have you seen any of the stills for this movie?
I have.
Are you excited about this movie?
Are you excited? Are you stoked? Emma Watson?
Yeah.
Emma Watts?
You know, because like I wasn't excited about Cinderella, but that was cool. So.
Surprised you, right?
Yeah.
How did you feel about Maleficent?
I didn't see Maleficent. I'm sorry.
Oh, okay. Man. Sorry. You didn't want to see... What's the dude from District 9? What's the guy's name?
Prince Stefan.
No, he's got a crazy name. It's like Charlo. You know what I'm talking about? South African guy? Anyways, he was in that.
I know what you mean, huh?
He's good in everything. I like love him.
He was horrible in this movie.
He was great.
He was horrible in Maleficent.
No, his
like
character,
acting-wise? Or
no, his
like
acting was great.
Ethically.
Both. Like, just
no.
all
but,
of it was
but
bad.
But that's why he's good. Ugh. Because, you know, his first movie was District 9.
I know. He was great in District 9.
Yeah, and have you seen him in...
No, I haven't seen him in anything except Maleficent.
In Elysium?
No, I haven't seen
Elysium.
Elysium. She hates the way I say that movie. She just hates my accent.
Oh God.
Anyway, so going back to this, the stills look amazing, and they have recently announced, much to my delight that there will be no Broadway songs. None of the Broadway Beauty and the Beast songs will be in the movie. It's That's only right. going to be the ones from the animated classic.
Thank God.
Yeah, thank God. But they will have three new songs.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
And we only know the names of two of them. One is called Forevermore, and the other one is called Day in the Sun.
Have they? I want to hear Emma Watson sing, first of all.
Can she sing? Is she a singer?
Who knows?
She can do anything.
Has she sung in anything?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't think so.
Honestly, Emma Watson is an astronaut. She can do whatever she wants to. She's Emma Watson.
Yeah.
I give it to her.
Yeah, I like her. She's definitely like the most, well, I don't know, Daniel Radcliffe.
He did some stuff. He did
Poor Rupert.
Rupert Grint.
He drives an ice cream truck.
His name, it just sounds like he was destined to fail.
I was obsessed with him when I was 12.
But you hated him as Ron.
Yeah, he's a terrible Ron. They're all terrible.
Well, yeah, Emma
They're
Watson's
all
not
terrible.
Great as Hermione.
Emma
she's
the trio
way too
acting is
for that
wrong.
No,
like,
she's the best.
Straight
wait, wait,
up
wait,
wrong.
Wait, you're going to argue that Daniel Radcliffe was wrong as Harry Potter?
Yes.
Okay, all right. I'm not going to fight you on it because like you're the expert.
I am the expert.
I was fine.
Who would James be in the Harry Potter universe real quick? Lupin?
Oh, he'd be a pretty. Like, just you're just saying that because like he kind of looks
kind
like that.
He looks like a young, more handsome.
No, he wouldn't be Lupin though. Like he's more of a serious than a Lupin.
I don't know. He's not that serious.
I'm pretty dour.
He's honestly more of a James. James Potter.
Yeah.
Ooh.
James Potter.
Nobody dislikes James. Oh, Snitch.
James
no,
Potter.
No, James
a
Potter is a. Isn't annoying kind of a as a kid, but yeah. then grows up to be a great dude. But like he's got that like playfulness.
It's kind of like me though.
Prankster.
I was annoying as a person.
Really? You're God. Honestly like kind of like a Weasley twin.
No, you're not. He's.
I'm not that mischievous.
Oh my goodness.
By the way, I just hawkish, want to say that this is unofficially know. Because we did this last episode too. This is unofficially Harry Potter.
Yeah, I bring too. It up yeah. as much as I can.
Well, like she's got two tattoos: a Snitch and a Mickey Mouse.
Yeah.
So like that's her life. That's a jam. For me, it's Star Wars and Disney, so that works out well.
Okay, but what I was reading the article about. Beauty and the Beast.
Beauty and the Beast. B-A to B.
What I
want to
know is the song Human Again going to be in it?
Mm.
Because that was originally supposed to be in the animated movie, was cut, was put back in, is now in the movie.
I don't
like that
That's
song.
A good question.
You
well,
know?
It is.
But like,
I don't know. What do you think?
Know,
you think it's going to be a 2-hour film?
It's gonna be a long.
It's gonna be.
Movie.
They might include it.
I think like give the people what they want.
I think they're putting Mother's Boy in that. It's gonna be great.
Proud of your boy from Aladdin. Boy. God, you dummy! Don't try to make a joke and then
that's
just botch
it. That's how I, that's
God.
How, like, look at my reaction. Like all I have to do is like say one thing.
No,
wrong.
But you did not do that on purpose.
I didn't do it on
You're
purpose, but
dumb.
Like I don't mind throwing him out there just to get that response from her.
Because I was like thinking like Mother's Boy. Where would that fit in the story of Beauty and the Beast? There's
no
Mother's
Boy. No mom anywhere.
God, I could just my Twitter's just gonna say Mother's Boy. Leo, you a Mother's Boy? No, I'm a mom. I'm proud of my mother.
He is a Mother's Boy.
Aw, me too, man.
He loves his mom.
High five for moms.
Sweet.
I love my
See, that
mom.
Turned around.
Anyway.
Not as much as us. We're proud of Anyway.
Yeah.
Moving on to live action here. We had some Beauty and the Beast there. We talked about Maleficent a little bit. Maleficent has a child. She's her descendant. And now she's going to be her descendant too.
Mm-hmm.
They're making Descendants too.
Mm-hmm.
They're making Descendants too.
They're making that sequel.
Guess what James watched before he got here?
Literally, like, the credits rolled and I left my apartment to come here.
Literally,
so,
everyone's gonna hate that we're talking about it.
Descendants.
It's Disney. It's Disney news.
Descendants.
Ding dong, Descendants.
Suddenly became such a big part of my
it's
life.
Huge. Yeah. Like, we just went to the Descendants meetup.
We went to the Descendants event.
Third tattoo.
My third tattoo is gonna be like
gonna say,
the
it's
Auradon
gonna say,
prep
rotten pressed. To the core.
The rotten to the core lyrics just all over my back.
Yeah, just an apple on your chest with like a
like the red dragon. Yeah. Just the lyrics.
No, but like it really, I don't know why. It's just like it's when it was gonna come out. We were like, people might really like this. Maybe we should like do a Thingamablogs week
yeah.
for Descendants.
Yeah.
And then like I'm working with Disney Channel to promote it.
It
now.
Just came out today.
My video.
Yeah, your video.
I was like, the movie did not.
No, the one you
yeah,
she worked
I did.
On.
Yeah, I'm doing
project.
Like videos
cool.
about Descendants.
Tell them
now.
Where they can watch that.
They can watch it on I'm Sarah Snitch YouTube channel. If
That's
you,
really good.
If you were to just search Descendants Disney Bounds.
And if you guys really check out that video and pay close attention to the cinematography, because whoever shot
Leo
that.
Leo shot it. Most of it.
Also, check out Alexander Payne's The Descendants starring George Clooney. It's a pretty good movie. You know? It's not bad.
No, but honestly, we were at this... to Leo's
I tried to hold it back. I couldn't. It was
we were at this Descendants event. in what was that?
We were getting sentimental there.
We were at this Descendants event in Downtown Disney where the cast was there and Kenny Ortega was there. Kenny Ortega is a great
director.
He's the best choreographer. Like, his movies have the best dancing. Newsies, if you didn't know.
Yeah, he comes out
Focus,
and they're like,
Focus, if you didn't
the creator
know.
Of
High School Musical, if you didn't know.
Every time they said one of his movies, the crowd like lost it. There was brains on the floor. People were just like, it was exploding minds. It was
We realized that this movie is literally this generation's High School Musical.
It is. Definitely. It felt very
Which
High School Musical.
Which is so weird.
But it's crazy because it was like literally babies already cosplaying as it is.
Yeah, there were
like
babies into cosplaying.
It, singing the songs.
Yeah.
Babies. They
just like
got
on stage and they're
it makes
like,
sense.
They say I'm evil. They say I'm bad. They say I'm wicked.
What are you?
That make me glad.
Oh, you're glad. Okay.
I know the lyrics. Yeah. Sorry, those might have been
Well, it was great. Like 6 year olds on stage singing it.
No, you got someone for everyone. You got like the top Jafar son guy.
Yeah. You got like the techie, wimpy. Like,
yeah.
And it's then you fun. Got like Dopey son.
Yeah, I didn't catch that he was Dopey son.
He says it.
I know, I didn't catch
that. That's my favorite thing about the movie is that everyone's like, hey, I'm Sarah, like Linda's daughter. Like, that who, like, no one in the real world introduces themselves based on who their parents
are. Well, I do that. I do that.
We do that.
I do that all the time.
You're like, I'm Leo, son of Leo.
Yeah, I go, hi, I'm Leo, son of Leo Camacho. And because it's a joke, because I look exactly like, okay, you know, in movies when cartoon characters have babies and the babies come out looking exactly like the parents?
Yeah.
That's me and my dad.
Yeah.
I look exactly look like my dad. It's crazy. I actually look at pictures of him and I'm like, where was I when this happened, Mom? I don't remember.
Maybe it's because they're all like sons of princesses and princesses that they're like, hey, like, you might be my sister, so let me just tell you who my parent is.
Exactly.
It's like, I get it,
like,
but it's
I am Don
so
Quixote de la Mancha.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Right? It's like royals, maybe they walk around doing that.
Yeah,
you know?
That's true. Like,
or it happens in Game of Thrones. They're like, I am
Aragorn, son of Arathorn.
Yeah, yeah, like that.
Gimli, son of Gloin.
It was just so weird because, like, I'm like, oh, they just go to. Like, there's probably people who don't have famous parents at Auradon.
Yeah, can you imagine?
Yeah.
What do orphans say?
Yeah, I was about to say that. I'm Aladdin.
Yeah.
Son of
I'm a Harry
mama's
Potter.
Boy. Mother's boy, son of.
Mother's boy.
I am Cogsworth, son of Cloxmington.
Cloxmington.
Some people don't. Well, I was going to say, if you have parents in the Disney universe, you got to be proud of it. You got to, like, announce it because half of the Disney parents are dead. So.
Yeah, oh God. You're a rarity.
Like, hi, I'm Mal, daughter of Maleficent. She's still alive.
I thought they missed the opportunity. Like, they named Belle and the Beast's son Ben.
Ben.
They missed the opportunity to name him Adam.
That would have been amazing. Do you know that?
No.
There's like, everybody like says that the Beast's real name, because like obviously he should have a real name, because he was a person before he was turned into a beast.
He's a beast.
Everyone says that his name is Adam.
Adam.
Even
why,
though
where does that
was,
come from, do you know?
There's a lot of places.
Was it just
from.
like a book, one of those like golden
like trivia books.
Books,
and it was in like a video game?
And doesn't Snow White's prince have a name? Although
Ferdinand.
Ferdinand.
It's not real either. Yeah. But like none of it was ever confirmed, but like,
right.
I don't know. I think those things are fun.
I like those things.
Because it does make sense
like
for him
the
to have
dog,
a name.
The Ottoman dog from Beauty and the Beast, his name is Sultan, but I didn't know that because they tell you that in the sequel.
But
yeah,
isn't that the name of
the Sultan.
The Sultan is a position, but his name is Sultan. It's like naming your like
Sultan.
German Shepherd King.
Yeah.
You know?
Or
which, by the way, Khaleesi. Have you guys ever met a German Shepherd named King?
No.
Man, you're the first two people I've ever met.
You don't know King?
But it's the same thing, like how I really like how in the parks in Disneyland, like the Phantasmic Dragon's name is Murphy.
Yeah, but that's for like a very different reason.
That's like how Bruce is like the Jaws shark, right?
No, his name is Bruce.
Oh.
What? Oh, and like the Yeti, the Yeti on Matterhorn's name is Harold.
Why?
Are those like are those like
that.
Canonical names or are those like behind
no,
the
No, no,
it's
fan names.
It's behind,
fan
it's like, no, but it, like, I think it comes from like the Imagineers.
But where, so you don't know why Harold came to be. Because Murphy is obviously Murphy's Law, anything that can happen will happen, because that dragon has failed countless times. But why like Harold, like everything that can herald will herald? Is he the Herald to Galactus?
No, God. I just know their names.
Sarah, if you're going to dump this on me, I need to know the facts.
Yeah, you better come prepared.
Be prepared.
Chelsea says Aladdin is the son of the hottest Disney dad. So
oh, that's
you're
right.
Wrong.
Oh,
he's
the king.
That's right. King of Thebes. But he's not like, hi, my name is Aladdin, son of Alibaba.
Is his name Alibaba?
Alibaba in the
King
of Thieves?
No, that's the original story.
That's the original story.
I don't
story.
Think
is he not Alibaba?
I don't know.
He's just the 40 thief. What is it? What's
Someone
the name
tell
of the
us. Someone tell us his dad's name.
In the chat room right now.
No.
What's Aladdin's dad's name? And his mom, she might have a name. It's like Clay Aiken.
What if it's like Chet?
It's Clay Aiken.
Chet. This is dad's name.
Hi,
my name is
Kasim.
Kasim. I am Kasim. You're humble. No, that's the thief.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about?
Oh my God.
Oh, what, the little guy?
I'm just a humble thief. Yeah, remember, like, he's going to go into the.
He is not the diamond in the rough.
No, he's not. Like, but his name is Kasim, right?
I don't think he has a name.
No, he definitely has a name. He says it. He's like, I am Kasim, a humble thief. that's why, because it's probably Hasim.
Does he have, like, peanut butter in his mouth the whole time?
Oh my God.
He's like,
let's talk more about this.
I think that's it. That's the last piece of news. We have nowhere else to move to.
There's no more news.
There's no more news for the week.
We had to end on Kasim.
We could talk about Donald
in the chat room.
Oh my God.
I'm just going to throw out. Chat room's is basically my Google. We're not leaving until we find out his actual name.
No.
Oh, yo!
Guys, I looked it up. It's Kasim.
Every week. It is?
It is Kasim.
It is Kasim. Thank you, guys. In your faces. Because I am worthy of the lamp.
Mm-hmm. Someone says the Jaws shark was named Bruce after Steven Spielberg as a lawyer.
Yep. Thank you, Irene.
Is that so? In Finding Nemo, the Jaws.
That was
the
a throwback.
Oh,
that's
gotta be a reference.
I thought that's what you were talking about.
Oh yeah. No.
That's very cool that you knew. I did not know that.
Oh, I'm a big horror movie fan.
So I bet you that is a throwback. To are you really? Oh, we're gonna talk about that after this.
We'll definitely talk
about
it.
We're gonna have a duel of the fates after this. Sarah, I'm sorry that we annoyed you so much.
Oh my God.
Oh man.
I promise next week I'll tone it back.
I just like felt so much shade behind me the entire time.
It's because you got broad shoulders because you worked out. You did a cool program. Congratulations. What was it?
This is a lot of news this week.
Tell them about what you do, man.
Hammer and chisel. It's not out yet.
Okay, so you can't talk about it.
Okay.
thank you guys for watching. Thanks for hanging out in the chat room. We really appreciate it. Make sure you hit us all up on social media so we can keep talking about Disney. On Twitter, I'm at Leo Zombie, and everywhere else it's at Mr. Leo Zombie, including YouTube. So hit me up. Let's talk about Star Wars, Disney, Duel of the Fates, which is my favorite jam right now. and let's get nerdy together. How about you guys?
James A. Janisse on Twitter, at James A. Janisse, also Instagram, and on YouTube, Practical Folks.
Check that out. It is
Practical
really funny.
Folks, so
Practical
funny.
Practical Folks.
And I am Sarah Snitch. Sarah Snitch on everything except I'm Sarah Snitch on YouTube. And, of course, Thingamavlogs, where we post videos every single day of the week.
And they're all Disney-related, so tune in and check
that
out.
And we will see you here next week for more Disney movie news.
That's right, guys.
I'll watch.
You'll be here in the chat.
Kevin Undergaro, Phil Svitek, and the entire Popcorn Talk Network. We would like to thank you for tuning in. For questions or comments, be sure to visit popcorntalk.com. I'm Sir Richard Wentworth, and this has been a presentation of the Popcorn Talk Network. The views expressed herein are those of the hosts only, and do not necessarily reflect the views of the Popcorn Talk Network or its owners or principals.